God's name is Yahuwah or Yahweh. Jesus' name is Yahusha or Yeshua or Yahawashi. The Holy Spirit's name is Ruach-Kadesh. These are their original Hebrew names. I come in my Father's name, and ye receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him ye will receive. John 5:43. Dad, grant us the ears, minds, hearts, knowledge, wisdom, and understanding to be able to hear and comprehend your words today. Oh Dad, let us not only hear your words today, but let us all hear your voice today. I know that you want hell empty. I know that you have anointed your servants to bring your word exactly like you wrote it on your servants' hearts. And I want to personally thank you that you will help me to bring it exactly the way you prescribed it this day, tomorrow, and forever. I thank you and give you all the praise and the glory. I worship you in the mighty name of Yahusha. I love you, Dad. Welcome. Come on in, sit down, and let's learn with a pure heart what our Father is saying to us all right now. We left off saying what God said about what we are going to be doing in the kingdom of heaven and what we will also be doing on the Sabbath day in the kingdom. We may have been deceived. Chapter 3. Let's begin. Isaiah 66:24. And they shall go forth and look upon the carcasses of the men that have transgressed against me. For their worm shall not die, neither shall their fire be quenched, and they shall be abhorring unto all flesh. We are going to go forth every Sabbath day and new moon to the lake of fire to look at all the Sunday worshipers, look at all the adulterers, look at all the murderers, all the kidnappers, all the liars, all the Satan worshipers. We are going to go forth every Sabbath and new moon to do this. We're going to be looking at all the bodies in the lake of fire. That's what this is talking about. Every Sabbath day, we're going to go forth to look at the Sunday worshipers and those that were teaching people to keep Sunday worship and not the Sabbath day. Every Sabbath day is going down like this. You've got four Sabbaths, sometimes five, in a month, and you have a new moon every month. So between five and six times a month, sometimes, we're going to go to the lake of fire. We're going to praise the Most High, get together in worship, and then we're going to go to the lake of fire to watch. Christ talked about this with the parable of the rich man and the poor man. Lazarus, he talked about this. He says there's a great gulf fixed between us, and all the rich guy wanted was a drip of water on his tongue, and he couldn't forget it. We are going forth every Sabbath to look at bodies burning in the lake of fire, all the people that transgressed against the Most High, all the people that did that. That's a sight to see. This is where people have to make decisions only if you want to be one of the people that's willing to take that chance of being the one that's in the burning flame. Then you're going to understand what the words forever and perpetual means. Because you think it's a joke. You think it's just something cute, something that he just thought to say that time. We can just do whatever we want. That's when you're going to understand what forever means. After a million years, you're going to be sitting there like saying, I got another million years. I got another million years after that. Then I got another billion years. Then I got another billion years after that. You're going to understand, really understand what it means forever. And then those that kept the covenant when the Most High says the Sabbath day forever, they are going to understand what forever means as well. And they're going to be glad they understood something as simple as what forever meant. So, who implemented Sunday worship? Yes, you guessed it. The Roman pagan Christian church. The Romans, they're the ones who implemented that. 300 years they waited, 300 years after Christ. And then they said, we're going to start changing stuff up. They kicked and expelled all the Jews out of Rome, and then they became the so-called authoritative source over the Bible. And then they're the ones who started implementing many of their old ancient pagan philosophies and doctrines, Sunday being one of them. They've always worshipped on Sunday. Sunday is the commemoration of the sun god, and most ancient civilizations had worship of the sun god. The Babylonians, Nimrod, that's who they worshipped and deified as the sun god. The Egyptians, Ra, their sun god. The Greeks, Helios and Apollo, their sun god. The Romans, Sol Invictus, their sun god. Many ancient civilizations worshipped the sun. It's not anything new. Modern day America, who's the sun god today? The misrepresented character in the Bible who they call Jesus Christ. That's the new sun god, because the way they depict Christ today is not the same guy in the Bible. All they're doing is using a character, and they've taken him and they've molded him and they've customized and are customizing him to fit an old ancient pattern of sun gods and using the Bible to mask it over, because nobody in today's time is going to worship the sun knowingly. But the higher ups, they know. See, they get power from doing this. They get paid for doing this. So they came up with a solution to have people inadvertently worship the sun and worship Satan. Because that's what it is. It's Satan worship. So they got you worshiping the sun or Satan and got you thinking that you're really following the Bible, when those two don't really have anything to do with each other. All you've got to do is is study the Bible. Not just read the Bible, but you've got to study the Bible. You've got to study the Bible. Now, I know most people don't take the time to study the Bible in this busy workaday world we live in. But as a voice sent to you, you'd better start to study. Not just read it, but study it. Now, reading is a start, but studying is a relationship. Studying is wanting to crawl up into Yahuwah God, the Most High's mind, and truly understand what He is saying to you individually. You've got to study the Bible. You've got to ask yourself, what is it? Why is it a day called Sunday? And why are we going to worship on this day? Why is it called Sunday? Does the sun shine more? Is the sun out for more hours on Sunday than any other day of the week? Is it a little bit more orange or yellow on Sunday? What is the sun doing for it to be called Sunday? What is it doing? Is it a little bit hotter on Sunday? I'm trying to find out why it is called Sunday. You're going to find out that it is called Sunday because that's exactly what it means. It's the sun's day. The day where you commemorate the sun. That's why it's called that. There's no reason why it is called Sunday other than that. And that goes right over people's heads. You don't know that you are worshiping the sun. You don't know that you are worshiping Satan. That's what you're doing. You're worshiping the sun, Satan, in the form of the sun. That's what you're doing, whether you want to accept that or not. Now, I know this is not popular, but this is the Bible. And listen, I don't have any problem, me personally. I can care less if people want to worship on Sunday. I was in it too, until I was sent to these scriptures, and then oops. So I understand if you want to keep worshiping on Sunday, it's tradition, then do it. I know that I am doing my part to search out the scriptures and show you what the Bible says. So if you want to worship on Sunday, go for it. I don't have a problem with people wanting to worship Satan. So if you want to do it, go for it. The problem comes in when people try to say that the Most High or the Bible says that Sunday is our day of worship. It is not. That's when the problem comes in, because now you're lying. Now you're purposely deceiving the people. If you want to do Sunday worship, just say you want to worship Satan. Just say that that's what you prefer to do. Just say that I prefer to worship the sun. But don't try to add the Bible into the mix to say that the Bible said, because it's clear that the Bible does not ever say anything about worshiping on Sunday. That's a pagan day. Now, let's not get what I'm saying twisted and confused, because you can worship on Sunday. You can worship Sunday. You can worship Monday. You can worship Tuesday. You can worship the Most High on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. You can worship Him 24 hours a day. That's not the case. The case is that there's one day that is mandatory for you to worship. See, that's another Christian cop-out. Well, I worship the Most High every day of the week. No, you don't. You pick Sunday to do the holy convocation when you get together with other believers. You don't do that every day of the week and on the Sabbath day. The Most High said one specific day. Everything else is optional, but there's one day that is mandatory. That's the difference, see? One day is mandatory. All the other days, all the other ones are optional. You can't switch them around. Who are you to switch them around? You can't make Sunday the mandatory day and everything else optional, or Tuesday the mandatory day and everything else optional. See, it doesn't work that way. The Most High said the Sabbath day, which is Friday sundown to Saturday sundown, because the evening and the morning were the first day. The day starts with the evening. So you bring in the pagan rituals and the pagan philosophy and try to make it seem like the Bible says we need to do these things. Listen, that's where the problem comes in. Listen, you want to go worship Satan? By all means, go do it. Go worship Satan and live it up. That's my philosophy on it. See, that's the beauty about teaching the scriptures. I don't have to try to convince anybody or get converts. My job is to give you the opportunity to see both sides of the story, and then you decide, see? You decide. I can't decide for you. And the Most High is not going to decide for you. See, you've got to decide what you're going to do from here, and you would think that it wouldn't be a problem for most people to say, you know what? I guess it is wrong for us to be doing Sunday worship. We should really get into doing what the Most High says and get back into the covenant of the Sabbath day worship, which is on the seventh day. But most people won't let it go because there's a spirit leeching on to them. There's a spirit behind Sunday worshiping because you're dealing with a totally different entity. Some people have people in the room right now listening that's got a problem with this, even though no matter how many scriptures you show them, they still want Sunday worship. Old grandma who's been in the church 50 years, she wants Sunday worship because she's programmed that way. Because her grandma went to Sunday worship and her grandma went to Sunday worship. And she doesn't care about what the Bible says about it. That's why Paul says in Colossians 2:8, beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ. You've got to beware of that. People want traditions. There's a spirit leeching on to people. So you have to understand, when people don't want to keep the Sabbath day, you're not really dealing with that person. You're dealing with that spirit that's leached on to them, and it does not want to let that Sunday worship go, because Satan has his legion of demons leeching on to these people. They don't want to let it go. There's a demon inside them fighting. It's the inward man that's fighting, that's grabbing, that's pulling. They don't want to give up Sunday, because as soon as you give up Sunday worship, that Sunday demon goes away. See, the demons don't want to go away. He's comfortable in his vessel, in his house. See, the people get comfortable. People don't want to give up. It's only one day prior, and people don't want to give it up. No matter how many scriptures you show them, no matter how much wisdom is in the Word of God, they don't want to hear that. Christ came down to tell you when the Sabbath is, yet it doesn't matter that the Bible tells you, huh? None of that matters, huh? They want to keep the Sunday worship. There's that spirit behind it, and there's a God they are dealing with behind that Sunday worship. Listen, my advice to all people out there, when you read this Bible, you have to read it without any Christian influence. You have to go over this whole thing again, because Satan is so infiltrated in the Christian church that something so simple as Sunday worship can throw you. How would this be able to slip through people's minds when you really study and read the Bible? Really study the Bible, I mean. When you read the Bible without Christian influence, when you just read it straight through and you run across scriptures that says things like a perpetual covenant, and you get all the way to the New Testament and you read stuff like, okay, they got together for the first day of the week. Nowhere in your mind would you come to the conclusion that the Sabbath is on Sunday without Christian influence. Well, this is the new Sabbath day. There is no way you would come to that conclusion. The reason why you have that conclusion is because of all the Christian influence. You keep hearing it on the television, Sunday, 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 Sunday. So your mind automatically goes to that state. When you see something like that, you automatically believe it. Like, okay, well, enough people have been saying it. It must be true. No, it isn't. No, read the Bible, study the Bible without any Christian influence. You will never reach the conclusion that the Sabbath is on Sunday. Nobody after Christ came with that conclusion. That all of a sudden now we have a new Sabbath day? That's unheard of. That's not biblical. That's not scriptural. That's a tradition and philosophy of men. That's what that's dealing with. That's what that's dealing with. Listen. So with that, I pray you have been edified and that you understand now without a shadow of doubt what the Sabbath day is and that you need to worship on that day. You can worship all other days, but the day that we're talking about, the Sabbath day, is mandatory to worship on. Be it the will of God, we will do another teaching right after this one, teaching on this, and we will be able to break down on how to keep the Sabbath. We'll go more in depth on how to keep the Sabbath and why we should keep the Sabbath. But for now, you know you have to keep the Sabbath. That's the day of worship. No Sunday churches. You shouldn't be going to no Sunday-only churches. You shouldn't be dealing with that. That's dealing with paganism and Satanism. That's dealing with the traditions of men. Those are offsprings of the Roman Catholic Church. That's what that is. And that is not what I'm saying. That's what the Bible is saying. I leave you with this. Liars are the cause of all the sins and crimes of the world. A lie travels around the world while the truth is putting on her boots. If you tell a big enough lie and tell it frequently enough, it will be believed. Look at our country. Now, they say is often a great liar. Listen, conscience is God's built-in warning system. Be very happy when it hurts you. Be very concerned when it doesn't. Remember, lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but they that deal truly are His delight. That's Proverbs 12:22. And with that, I say peace, harmony, wholeness, completeness, prosperity, welfare, and tranquility. Let us pray. Father, thank you for your word today. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for your majestic presence, your wisdom, your knowledge, your understanding that you pass on to us if we would just but listen. Thank you for your Son, Yahushua. Thank you for HaKadosh, your Holy Spirit. Thank you for the privilege to be able to worship you. And thank you for teaching us what day we are supposed to worship you. In the name of Yahushua, I pray. I love you, Lord.